You're never more than 10 minutes away from traffic and transit news weekday mornings on WCBS News 88.
And the News 88 three-day weather outlook for the New York metropolitan area. Clear skies giving way to some cloudiness overnight. Diminishing winds, still very cold, 15 to 20 in the city. Teens in most of the suburbs. Maybe some single numbers in certain of the interior sections. Tomorrow, variable amounts of clouds and sunshine. Breezy, moderating temperatures into the mid-30s to near 40. Tomorrow night, it's going to be cloudy with a chance of a few showers of rain. Maybe that will be mixed precipitation. Lows staying in the 30s for New Year's Eve. And for the new year, clearing and cold on Friday, then fair and cold at least through Saturday. Clear now, 18 degrees in mid-Manhattan.
You're listening to news and information 24 hours a day here on WCBS News 88.
Good evening, I'm Bill Fan at 7:30, and these are some of the major stories we're covering on News 88. Algona, Iowa, seven people are found dead in what authorities feel may be another case of murder-suicide. Russellville, Arkansas, suspicions of incest, including the fathering of a child by a daughter, are leveled at the man thought to have killed 16 people. Washington, the U.S. expels two Chinese diplomats. New York, three more people are now under consideration for the New York City Schools Chancellor position. Also just ahead on WCBS, Bill Schweitzer will have sports. St. John's takes on Kansas U for the ECAC Championship tonight. Our broadcast of the contest getting underway around 9 o'clock. The Nets host Washington will have a report on skiing conditions. And Ken Pruitt will have business news. The Dow Industrials gained 23 points. Police in Algona, Iowa are investigating what apparently is the country's second mass killing in less than a week. Gene Meyer, assistant director of the Iowa Division of Criminal Investigation, says seven bodies were discovered in an Algona home by police who were alerted by a neighbor or a friend. Algona police say the deaths are being investigated as murder-suicide. Police roped off an area around the home of John and Agnes Driesman. The neighbors say that several relatives, including children, had been at the home for the Christmas holiday. Meyer said he did not know whether any of the victims were children, but he said no one was found alive in the house. The investigation continues into that mass killing in Arkansas. We get the latest from Bill Simmons.
Sheriff's deputies investigating 16 murders in Arkansas obtained a warrant authorizing them to search victims' cars. Affidavits supporting the warrant say deputies are looking for a crowbar, a claw hammer, rope, guns, and ammunition. In custody is 47-year-old R. Gene Simmons, and most of the victims were his relatives. Some of them left cars parked at the Simmons house about 13 miles north of Russellville, Arkansas. In another development, judge signed an order to commit Simmons to a hospital for a psychiatric examination. Bill Simmons, Russellville, Arkansas.
WCBS News Time coming up to 7:33. This country kicks out a couple of Chinese diplomats. The story from George Guetta.
The State Department says two Chinese diplomats have been expelled from the United States. Although no reason was given, a published report said the two had been arrested last week by the FBI on suspicion of espionage. The State Department said only that the Chinese were ordered out of the country for activities incompatible with their diplomatic status. The men reportedly were arrested after one of them, an assistant military attaché, received what he thought were classified documents during a meeting with an American counterintelligence agent. George Guetta at the State Department.
WCBS News Time, 7:33.